criteria, it doesn't leave a whole lot of areas. Some have asked, why didn't we look at the lot on... why we haven't made an offer for that property. I should say we have looked at it from time to time. There are very few opportunities. There is some concern, as I understand, about the soils that was operated as a gas station, beginning by Shell, I think, in 1961, and then by successors since that time. We do have reports in the building inspector's office, which have been reviewed. They do indicate that the soils are clean in those areas that were tested. It does not give a clean bill of health to the entire property. Nor does this property have a clean bill of health. But I do want to make clear that where the gasoline was discovered in the front of the property, that particular aspect of the property has been cleared. Aside from that, would like to mention that I have had some discussions with the current tenant. They are willing to, by verbal agreement, lease it for an additional two-year period from the town, the current rent that's now being paid, as I mentioned. I don't have the formal signed agreement yet. It would be premature to do that, at this point, but I would have the town attorney draft up a lease with a very similar provisions to the one you see that the lease is now that Pond Cove Associates, the current owner, has with the tenant. I am proposing that the funds come out of the undesignated fund balance in the general fund in the amount of $165,000. I'm also suggesting that I get together sometime between now and your next meeting with the town council chairman to look at a process of how we're going to review this property to meet the town's longer-term public safety needs. Not immediate, but short-term, we are looking a couple of years away. We're not looking immediate. At the same time, I don't want to raise expectations that we can go with the current situation over there for another 10 years. It is something that we do want to be addressing. And quite frankly, we've looked at it for both fire and police. I'm not convinced as to what is its best use. I do think it's important to have available and to particularly look at a public safety use. But I think we need to do a complete look at cost alternatives as well as particularly impacts on the town center. The town center planning committee looked at this particular lot, looked at this entire stretch along here, does want to promote more commercial activity. Which, we would be taking that out of the commercial base, but then again, it does provide for, the town use as well. And that's a difficult issue to address. The one other issue I've heard through the community the last few years is concern about the loss of taxation revenue. We do have it assessed at $193,000, roughly, $194,000, which means we'll be losing about $3,600 a year in revenue. As I look at the building, I look at the tenant income over the 2 years, would be about $21,000-$22,000. The loss property tax income would be about $7,200. I'm estimating would have about $3,000 a year in expenses for insurance and upkeep that would still need to be done to make sure that the roof doesn't leak, that type of thing. And as well as looking at the cost of money, the fact that the $165,000 isn't invested is another thing we need to look at. And what all the numbers show me that it's about a break-even deal over the next 2 years. It comes out almost exactly even. So we are covering our cost, our foregone revenue, but that's it. So I would recommend that you authorize the land to be acquired. I should mention one thing. This includes the gas station lot, service station lot, and the one in back with the barn as well.
Thank you, Michael McGovern. Can I have a motion on this? The manager's recommendation?
Well, let's get it going.
Councilor,
I would move that we approve the town manager's recommendation and acquire the property as suggested in his memo of May 4th, 1994.
Thank you.
Second motion.
Moved and seconded that we acquire the property as recommended by the town manager in his memo to us of May 3rd, 1994. Discussion, please. Counselor Nell.
A few people have called me and expressed concern that at the time when we're building a new school, that we're spending money left and right, and we're going to spend money on this property and put a building on it and so forth. I think we do have to look at while we may do something about a public safety building, it's something we have to address. Just voting on this property does not guarantee that anything will be done with the public safety building. As the manager pointed out, we could buy this property without affecting taxes at all if we took the money out of undesignated funds. And my thinking on this project, I'll tell you a little story. When Grandfather Brown was off in World War II, they had about 60 acres in Cape Elizabeth then, but right next to the house, a for sale sign went up because there was one lot right next to the house that they didn't own. And normally, Eva would have called Lester before she went out and bought the real estate, but she felt that it was important to control what happened right next door to their house. And so within a day or two, she went over and bought the land. And I think that there's an argument, a strong argument, to acquire this land because it may not be available for a number of years. We may have a need for it in 10, 20, or 30, or 50 years. And if the town doesn't buy it, they may lose that chance. And I think we have a responsibility to look down the road at what the town's needs may be. It is right next door. It is priced below the assessed value. If we did not do something at this time, it's possible that they could sell to a business, which would then invest X amount of money in the property, and then 5, 10, 20 years down the road, it might be that much more difficult to buy because of a going concern over there. It is possible to buy this now with undesignated funds to offset some of the maintenance costs with some of the income that we could receive from the property until such time as we can do something different with it. So for those reasons, I would tend to be in favor of this purchase.
Thank you. Other discussion? Is there anybody? We got quite a few that stayed tonight, and I know they didn't stay to hear us talk, so maybe they want to say something on this. I think as the chairman, I would like to open it up to anybody out there that would like to. Yes, please, sir. Give your name, if you will, and your address, and tell us that you're in favor of it.
My name is Don Lewis, and I live at 10 Longfellow Drive, and in 15 years there, I haven't felt compelled to come before the council until I read in the Cape Courier the fact that the town was considering paying $165,000 for less than an acre of land. Sarcastically, I guess if you're willing to pay $165,000 an acre, then I've got a quarter of an acre I'd like to talk to you about. At a time when we're faced with significant economic challenges in this town, I think that prudence and caution should be the bywords in these discussions and these proposals. We're embarking on a huge school renovation project, which is costing us, the taxpayers, a tremendous amount of money. We're encountering spiraling sewer costs. Those costs are spiraling upward continually. I think the town's just acquired the Poor Farm. I didn't understand the rationale for that, but it was a major outlay, I think. We've just purchased a new fire truck and so forth. And And again, the taxpayers are encountering steadily increasing taxes. All the while, we're faced with eliminating school programs like living skills, industrial arts, things of that nature. And if we've got $165,000 in undesignated funds, I strongly urge you to consider putting those into those programs that we're losing in the school system and in the education of our children, and things that are more important. You say that that land may not be available a few years from now. So what? There's all kinds of land in this town, and there will be for years to come. So when you have a specific purpose for it, then and only then, please consider the acquisition of that land. So I recommend strongly voting against that tonight. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Anybody else that's out here tonight? Yes, sir. Come up.
John Ridge, Pleasant Valley Avenue. I'd like to ask a couple of questions for clarification. With whom does the problem of the soils, if there is a problem in the future, the prior owner, or once the town, if they were to purchase it, if a problem arose?
Goes with the property.
With the property. Okay, another question. What properties are presently owned by the town that might possibly be sites for these ideas that we're discussing tonight that wouldn't expend any funds? Portion of Fort Williams, that's owned by the town, up by Shore Road. Down back here, there's plenty of land down in the back. I think you voted tonight to spend to do a bond for $200,000 for the handicapped and the disabled, and you had $165,000 sitting in this unexpended fund. I think your money would have been better spent in that area as opposed to, like this gentleman said, spending $165,000 for an acre of land. And you're taking commercial property off the rolls, and if we have ample property in the rear or over on the other sites, maybe I didn't pause long enough for you to answer my question in reference to what properties we own.
Do you want me to ask the questions as he asked them?
Wait.
We own, if anyone looked at the Cape Courier, someone mentioned it to me today, there's a whole big list of town-owned property. It's an issue, we have Fort Williams, but it's an issue. What do you want to use Fort Williams for? What's an appropriate response area from where you want public safety? Do you want them in one end of town? Do you want them in the center of town? Off to either end. There's the Poor Farm that
True.
Will soon be unencumbered, other than the area that was the former dump. We own a lot down here that a gentleman just tried to buy some of. It's very low. Lots of filling would need to be done, so it's a tough lot. We own Lions Field. It has some restrictions on it. What am I forgetting? We own some Little League fields.
But are any of them appropriate for the function that
we're
discussing tonight?
I don't think any of the sites I've mentioned are appropriate.
Including behind here in the town hall or over in that area? That's
no,
not adequate?
No, that's not appropriate.
And would the property at Fort Williams be appropriate?
I'm not the judge of that.
Can I answer that?
Go ahead, Councilman.
Mr. Ridge, we don't have to rush out and build that fire station there. It seems to me that although it is hanging over there, I think the actual expenditure of another building has to be looked at in the context of the budget. And I think you raised a good point there. But what is appealing there, and the reason it would be nice to have, is the location. I mean, a fire truck, if you wanted to put a fire station, out on the town farm property, that would be fantastic for that part of town. But to me, there's a tremendous advantage if one were placed here, a fire truck could head out the door and could go down Shore Road, Ocean House Road, 77 right, 77 left, Scott Dyer Road. And so for that reason, I think that when and if we could find the money to do something about a public safety building, if that is determined to be the ideal thing, I think there's advantage to that. In any event, I still think that there's an advantage to owning the property right next to your property. And one other point, I know it would take it, in a sense, off the tax rolls, but that would be offset, I think, in between the time that we bought it, if we decided to buy it, and the time we were able to afford a building, that the money that would the cost of maintaining it would be offset by the rent you would charge whoever's there.
For 2 years, he said, primarily, right? That was your assumption? That's the way you did your projection? That's the way I understood it when you explained it.
Sure. I mean, I don't think he would rule out that it could offset those costs in future years, too. I think you could always do something different. If it's a valuable piece of property, I'm sure we could always find someone, a tenant, that would like to be there.
Well, is the proposal that a public safety building house both police and fire? Is that what you're proposing? Or are you going to possibly expand the fire on the site where it is and move the police to another location?
I'd like to clarify it, if I might, for you, Mr. Ridge. As far as any proposal goes, there isn't any. We're not even saying that that land will be used by the police or the fire or any other department in town. What we're only saying is that it's ideal to have it come at this particular time, and it's something that we should pick up and hold until we find out if we do need it. If we find out we do need it and we haven't got it, it's going to be very expensive to find something else that's as ideally suited as that piece is, being in proximity to the town of itself. Supposing, just to make it clearer for you, supposing we leave one item over there and one item here. I don't know which one. Have no way of knowing right now. It would be a wonderful, absolutely wonderful town center going along with our town center plan that the council approved 2 years ago. And this is the reason. Please don't get the idea here tonight that there's any proposal. There is not. The only proposal that we have before us tonight is to vote yes or no on buying it. And the manager got this lease, which we put into the sales agreement, that we would have a lease on it for 2 years if possible. He is now arranging that. At the end of that 2 years, we may be exactly the same as we are tonight, looking for another tenant. We do not know whether it'll be 2 years, 5 years, 7 years, or 15 years before we might have a use for it. But we can't take the chance and let it go. That's the opinion of some of the council. Does that help you at all?
To a degree. Yep. I'm not totally satisfied with your rationale, but I would strongly recommend that you not buy it and not spend the money.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anybody else from the group that's here tonight that would like to come up and give their name and their address and have a few words? Yes.
Alice Rand at 1222 Shore Road. And I dabble a little in real estate. I also happen to be a neighbor of this area. And I feel very strongly that this would be a very wise investment for our town to make. Interest rates still are low. You are able to purchase the property at below assessed value, and I think these combination of financial considerations make this a very good investment and is a tribute to the vision of the town.
Thank you very much. Is there anybody else from the group that came down to see us tonight? Please. Thank you. Further discussion from the council? You have a Council McLaughlin.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I feel I need to speak because I have had a lot of thought go into this, as has the rest of the council. And I have spoken with some of you who are here as late as this afternoon and said I wasn't sure how I was going to vote tonight. And even when I got home after that softball game, there were still more phone calls coming in. I probably have had as many discussions about this issue as just about anything else since I've been on the council. I still have some very grave concerns about the lot. As Mr. Ridge pointed out, one of his questions was, what about responsibility for soil contamination? The holder of title at the time it's discovered is responsible. As Mr. McGovern mentioned, where the property was tested, they found the soils were okay. I believe that we might encounter some problems where they haven't been tested yet. If the proposal at some point is going to be to do a construction project on that site, there is a decent possibility in my mind that we will get into, we would get into a situation where we have to deal with contaminated soils. There are, however, ways to deal with that that would not break the bank. The motion that I have heard made was not, did not specify a kind of use to go on this property. If the motion had specified a use for the property, I would not vote for it. I think if you take the long-term picture of the town center, it's a wise decision at this time to purchase, to proceed with purchasing the property at the price that we have agreed to. It's not the original price people started at, and I think we've done some good negotiating to get us to a reasonable situation. I want to assure the people who have had the conversations with me that I did give this some very, very serious thought. I'm not doing this lightly, but I am trying to do my best and take a good long-term look at what is going to be in the town's best interest. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other discussion? Councilor Dahlbeck.
I just want to state that when this issue first came up and was discussed in council workshops, I think others here recognized that I was not a strong supporter of this, and I sort of considered it reluctantly and definitely only if I thought the price was going to be a good value and that we were not going to be overpaying for the piece of property. The school bond issue and the school construction has been discussed tonight. I think part of the reason for the magnitude of the school project is the fact that when action should have been taken well back to do some things with the school property, nothing was done and it was left to drag and finally became a very expensive project. I think that right now the price is such that I can go ahead and endorse making this acquisition and feel that down the road it will work out well. It is not necessarily for the public safety facilities on the one hand. On the other hand, some years ago, I think the public safety facilities were felt to be more in need than even the school project was at that time. At least I hadn't heard of the school project, and I had heard of the public safety needs. So I think we do have some needs as far as town facilities. This is right next door. Goodness knows what would happen to a large, massive paved lot if we don't buy it, and if it goes for some other use, it certainly is likely not to beautify the area. And I think it's an appropriate time maybe to step in.
Thank you. Other discussion? Council again. Marvin, how's that, huh?
I've been less than enthusiastic about this project from the start. However, for all the reasons stated tonight and the hour is late, I think it's a smart move at this time. I, too, dabble a little bit in real estate, and I think when you have an opportunity to buy a piece of property that's contiguous to yours at well below the current market valuation, I think it's time to move, and opportunity is knocking, we better open the door.
Thank you. Any other discussion? Councilor Jordan.
I just want to say that when this first started, I wasn't too hepped up about buying it myself. And I thought the town didn't need it, but as you look into the future of the town, I think sometime down the road that the lot is going to be valuable for the town. I understand there's a two-year possibility of a two-year lease there, and I would hope the tenant would be in, able to renew that for another 2 years or something like that. I would hope that we don't jump into something here within the next 2 years just to put something on the property, that we take a good hard look at it and probably wait maybe 5 years before anything is done with it. And I know it's a hard time as far as the school project, but as Councilor Dahlbeck, he hit it right on the head. We let the schools go, and whether residents are to blame that we didn't keep the schools up in the past, and if you had taken a tour through some of the facilities there, and lately, I think you'll agree that something had to be done, and done very soon. So I am going to endorse this. I've had some few people call me, I guess three or four, as you might say, and they're kind of against it, but as I explain it to them of the needs for the future, and it's not going to be taken off the tax rolls as far as revenue that will be received from it for at least 2 years, that I think it would be a wise investment, and this is why I feel I'm going to vote in the favor of it.
Thank you. Any other discussion? Councilor McLaughlin, please.
Mr. Chairman, when you get to the vote on this, I request a roll call vote, please.
What was that?
I request a roll call vote.
Yes. Can I have a couple of words to say before the vote?
Yeah, I said when you...
Okay, thanks. I just had to end this up that I've been for this since the beginning, and I admit it to anybody that knows me. I was on the Facilities Management Committee here for the town when Councilor McLaughlin was gracious enough to make me chairman of it. I met with the chief. We had quite a 12, 14 months with the chief and the chief of the fire department and the highway department. The highway department won the battle because they had the worst building, and they got the new building. And we should have given the police and the fire department their other buildings, their other quarters at that time, but being prudent and taking care of money and so forth, we couldn't do it. And then we got fooled. The school beat us to it. They jumped in, and education is very important. It had to be done, so they got it. Now, the police and the fire have waited since the Facilities Management Committee up through the Town Center Planning Committee. It was in that plan too, you know, that we look at any land that becomes available in the Town Center plan, and if it's prudent, buy it. If not, don't. They didn't tell us to buy it, but to look at it. So we've gone through two committees, and here we are tonight. I think it's the right thing to do, and I'm proud to sit here and say I've been for it since day one. Now, Councilor McLaughlin has asked for a roll call vote. That's in order. Will you please read the roll call for us, Ms. Lane? And we will vote. The motion is that we proceed with the purchase of the so-called property located at 316 Oceanhouse Road, as recommended by the town manager, at a price of $165,000.
Councilor Dalbec.
Aye. Yes.
Councilor Jordan.
Yes.
Councilor Linnell.
Aye.
Councilor Ginmarvin.
Yes.
Councilor McLaughlin.
Yes.
Chairman Chappell.
Yes.
6 yeas.
And that is 7-0?
Six.
6-0. Oh, yes, we have 6-0. That's good. Wonderful. I feel very good about it. Thank you. Item 176, to consider the warrant for the June 14, 1994 primary election and take any necessary action. Ms. Lane, please.
Thank you. On the podium this evening, I did provide you with a copy of the primary, the warrant. It did finally come in. It calls for a primary election on Tuesday, June 14th at the Cape Elizabeth High School Gymnasium. You will note that we are going to be now in two legislative districts, so it calls for the primary in Legislative District 24 and Legislative District 25. I was asked that you approve the warrant this evening.
May I have a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
Moved and seconded. Discussion? All those in favor? 7-0. Thank you. Item 177, to consider entering into executive session to discuss a property acquisition disposition matter and take any necessary action. Yes, but I got to get, you know, get that one first. Yes. Please.
No, that's fine.
May I have a motion on that, please?
Make a motion that we enter into executive session to discuss a property acquisition disposition
matter. Thank you.
Matter.
That's seconded.
Second.
Thank you. Motion seconded. Ms. Michael, will we need a vote after this? Yep. You got to come back here? No, we do not. So before we adjourn this part of the meeting, I got a citizen's discussion of items not on the agenda. We still have some citizens left here. Is there any item you'd like to speak about that was not on the agenda? Yes, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman, members of the council. My name is Fred Poulin. I live on Two Lights Road with my family. I would just like to bring to your attention, if it has not already been done so, and make it a matter of public information, that we had written a letter to Mr. McGovern last October, making the following suggestion. I'll just read the letter. It's very short. Mr. McGovern, we would like to propose that a pedestrian and bike lane be constructed on Two Lights Road. We feel that such a lane is needed on as much of the road as possible, but particularly on the section between Route 77 and Two Lights State Park. Two Lights Road leads to a state park, a popular oceanside parking area, and a busy seasonal restaurant. It's the site of a pick-your-own strawberry farm. The road has become increasingly popular among walkers, joggers, and cyclists. However, the road remains dangerous for all of its users because of the lack of a proper roadside pathway. The shoulders are soft, sandy, and narrow. Automobiles commonly exceed the speed limit, which is probably too high as it is, given the fundamentally residential character of this area. Passing is encouraged by a dotted center line, which the state claims to be unable to change because of line of sight regulations. In the last 8 years, Two Lights Road has been the site of two tragic accidents, which might not have occurred had there been a few more feet of pavement available for cyclists and automobiles. A pedestrian bike lane on Two Lights Road would greatly enhance the safety and pleasure of all those who use the road. We urge the Town Council to explore this concept and to work toward its implementation with us and other residents. And this was from myself and my wife. We intended to follow up on this with canvassing our neighborhood for signatures. We did circulate the letter to folks in many of the neighborhoods adjacent to Two Lights Road. We were unable to actually complete our wish to have a petition, but we did have many favorable telephone calls from people responding to this, and we had no negative comments. We have been given to understand that there may be some state funding or federal funding available for this type of project. We think it's a good idea, and would just like to urge you to use whatever process might be available to you to consider this sort of thing. And certainly as a resident, I would love to know what more I could do to help promote such a project. Thank you.
Thank you. Any other citizens that would like to say anything, or reporters? Councilor, Manager, yeah, McGovern.
Just very briefly, I read in this morning's paper that Charles Barnes had passed away.
Yes.
And Charles was the very long-time town attorney when I first started working with the town 16 years ago. He used to be at every council meeting, and he used to provide, you know, a lot of good input, I know, to my predecessors as well as to the town council. He was active, you know, on a number of issues, particularly was the sewer is the one that comes to mind, but coming up agreements, a lot of the language in our ordinances that we now have were written with Charles's legal hand, and several years ago he moved away from Cape Elizabeth. After being involved first as I think it was the Council of the Land Trust, and just, you know, as the obituary this morning indicated, just a very public-spirited citizen, and he was, you know, a good friend as well to you know, those of us that worked with him. Second, would want to thank the council and particularly department heads for and the boards and commissions for their work on the budget this year. I was very pleased that that process is over for another year, but it was good that, yeah, I think that, you know, you requested the boards and commissions to submit things this year, and that worked well. And the department heads, I think, did as good a job as ever in putting together a budget. And third, I noticed Senator Amaro out here, and I had mentioned in one of my budget notes that the budget you were looking at this evening would have been far, far worse if it had not been for the efforts of Jane Amaro. She was a real trooper up in Augusta this session on educational funding, and, you know, is the first lady of educational funding in Maine, and just, you know, I think just has done a stupendous job for the community on a whole lot of issues, but particularly on education funding. And I want to thank her for being in close contact throughout the session, and for all her very hard work on behalf of the taxpayers of Cape Elizabeth.
Is there anything else? You're not
That's
running
it.
For
no, I'm not running for anything.
Going to be Jane's campaign manager.
Oh, move. Thank you.
Executive session, please.
Move into executive session.
Well, he moves so slow.
No, to executive session.
Yes, we are going into executive
session. But we don't adjourn.
We approved that one. I want to get adjourned out of this meeting now. Can I, all right?
No.
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 Okay? All those in favor of adjourning from this meeting and going into executive session, so signify.
That's not the right thing.
I gotta wait till the end of that?
I already voted it.
Well, my goodness, you voted a little while ago.
We're in executive session.